Welcome to episode 3 of SA Music Box. We're 3 episodes in already, would you believe? My guest tonight is Antos Stella, the CEO of Content Connect Africa. We hope you enjoy her selection. Welcome to SA Music Box on Hot 91.9. I'm the Eskimo Writer. My guest tonight is Antos Stella. Antos is CEO of Content Connect Africa, which is one of the largest labels in Africa, in digital music especially. They're changing the game. And she's going to join us tonight on SA Music Box. Antos, welcome to SA Music Box, where we talk about your top 3 songs in SA music. And I know for somebody who's been in the industry as long as you, it becomes a very difficult thing to do. But it was a necessary challenge for me to pose to you, right? We've known each other also a long time. You are currently the CEO of Content Connect Africa. Now, for the audience out there, tell us in a nutshell what your company does in the music industry from an SA perspective.
Okay. Well, Savan, thank you so much for having me and inviting me to the show. Content Connect Africa is primarily a digital label. You actually had it in a nutshell there. We distribute music across the continent and across the world for South African and African, focusing on South Africa and the rest of Africa content. And that takes you to whether it's iTunes or whether it's Spotify, through Music Time on the network, MTN, any digital platform, we will provide you the music, South African and music from the rest of the continent. And our main aim is to really create new revenue streams for artists, be they established or up and coming.
Right. I know for a fact that, I mean, with my experience with your company, you've worked with many artists and created many, many revenue streams and successes with artists in the country. Now, in the industry, our industry has always been a very complicated industry. You know, not that everything's fair in love and war, as you know. And you've been a great advocate for gender equality in this industry, given where you started. How do females and how can females play a bigger role in this particular industry? If there was someone out there who wanted to get into it, what piece of advice would you give to them?
Yeah, so I mean, a subject very close to my heart. Still very disappointing to see not many women entering the music industry, and all for the right reasons, because as you say, I don't think anything's fair in love and war in the music industry. What I do believe is there's a great opportunity for women to enter with digital, with the age of digital, because you don't have to belong to anybody.
Yeah.
You don't have to be signed to a major label. You don't have to be an independent record label signed or independent on a distribution mechanism. That is why our CCA exists. We're a business hub.
Yeah.
But I see a lot more women coming to the fore, having their own labels, working in the network environment, working in digital.
Yeah.
And I'm hoping that that is going to open up and have a whole lot more women working in the industry.
Now, great, because I think in my history too, I mean, back in the day, women were generally in PR and in specific areas as opposed to into the commercial platform
and
digital areas.
They say in the music industry, women don't have any ears.
Oh, is that right?
That used to be in my days. That was a famous thing. Women don't have any ears.
Well,
right?
The times are changing.
We've always had ears. We've just not been heard.
Exactly. And speaking of ears, your first song for SA Music Box, what is it?
Oh, what a difficult choice. Maklatini and the Mahotela Queens, Kazette.
And why that song, Antos?
You know, I had to, it was a strong, it was really hard. It was a strong pull towards Stimela, who really brought me into the industry. It was the first time Whispers in the Deep was the first song I ever heard that really had a massive impact on me. But this song has seen me through my career, the 35 years I've been in business. Maklatini and the Mahotela Queens were already at Gallo when I started there.
Great.
And
you still work with
the
Mahotela Queens.
I still work with the Mahotela Queens, yeah.
Amazing. So that's it. That's Antos Stella's first choice. It's Kazette by Maklatini and the Mahotela Queens. Thanks, Angelos. That was a great choice. Maklatini and the Mahotela Queens. So what are your thoughts on live music opportunities in South Africa? Do you think there are a lot of music opportunities for people to play live at the moment?
Oh, I think it's so limited.
Yeah.
I think we have such a shortage of venues. you know, we talk about how to see a proper live performance with a full band.
Yeah.
You know, thank goodness we've got festivals like Joy of Jazz.
Yeah.
And Cape Town Jazz Festival, which really is not limited to jazz.
Right, right.
But we don't see many festivals. I mean, you know, we have the usuals. But in fact, someone asked me the other day, what can we go see live in Johannesburg?
You came up short of answers.
Short of answers, right. Yeah. I think the DJs and the clubs work. I mean, there's obviously a lot of opportunity. But to see live performances, I think we're very limited. So when you say, what are the opportunities? I suppose venues.
Do you think that we need more? So, I suppose my next question was...
Shut down.
Yeah, I heard.
Yeah.
Terrible news. It's a beautiful venue. Felt like you were somewhere else. What should be done and by whom to change this?
I think it's a catch-22, right? I mean, people need to be able to attend. We see massive attendances at... I mean, I'm sure you were all that Global Citizen. How many people go see live performances? On that scale, we see Casper Neves filling up, you know, the F&B Stadium. But the smaller venues, I think that we need to have more security around smaller venues and people to feel safe going to live shows.
I suppose that's a good point because, as you know, a lot of places where they play music are generally in areas that are nefarious.
Nefarious. Oh, my goodness. There's a song in there, really. Yeah. I think that as a whole, I really have to be honest with you. I don't know who's looking at opening venues. Maybe we need, I guess that where we're seeing a lot more of that happening is in the casino type hotels.
Yeah.
Which is where America's gone, right?
Which brings back to your point, which is those are secure venues.
Those are secure venues.
So I suppose the answer is having venue owners pick locations in more secure venues would allow people to
attend more. But it's a sad situation in the industry now. I mean, we used to really have to make big choices. Well, who we're going to see? Old Kippies. I mean, I don't know if you remember.
Yeah, I remember Kippies. Yeah.
To go to those.
Yeah, the Market
that
Theater.
That type of venue is kind of really what we're looking for. Yeah, Baseline. How sad was it that Baseline closed? You know, Baseline used to be in Melville. We need those more of those venues.
What was the other place in Melville that was there? The where all the rock bands played.
Oh, Roxy. Remember.
Roxy's.
Roxy's, yeah. Roxy's, right? Yeah. Places like Roxy's. Just where are they?
Yeah, I know,
where
do you go?
I mean, everybody used to go to, they knew what genre they were after and there was a venue to cater for that genre. It just doesn't work.
And now it's not as clear cut, right?
Yeah. So I don't have an answer.
So in the world of South African music, which South African song do you think has stood the test of time? And we would refer to it in the term we call evergreen.
Wow. Okay. Again. I mean, you're talking about general South African or what has been evergreen in my life.
I think I suppose evergreen in your life that is South African. I have to define that
very much because I think they're two very different. We could talk about a number of songs that are evergreen. For me, the soundtrack of my life has been Lucky Dube, Remember Me. I traveled around the world when Lucky was alive with Lucky. It was one of the biggest songs from Jamaica to Uganda. And he kind of literally introduced me to a massive audience across the continent.
Yeah.
And it's a song that's resonated with me. In fact, even now that he's passed on, it's a song that's very close to my heart.
Well, I think it's a wonderful choice. Lucky Dube is one of those artists where I've traveled the world.
Yeah.
And I found Lucky Dube in various countries on the shelves of music shops.
Yeah.
And he was one of those artists who best exported our culture to the rest of the world.
Yeah.
So great choice. Antos Stella's second choice on SA Music Box is Lucky Dube, Remember Me. Welcome back. That was Lucky Dube with Remember Me. Antos, Content Connect Africa has been going for how long now?
2005.
All right. Now, you and I have spoken over the years a lot about developing artists and new artists and emerging artists. What type of artist in the modern framework of music in the South African scene, what type of artist are you looking for? that you think will be successful?
You know, Sam, I have to be very honest with you. I hate putting music in a box.
Right.
I know a lot of people are chasing
the show's called SA Music Box.
Right. But I mean, the music box, and then there's music in a box.
Yeah, yeah. Fair enough.
I think that, I mean, if we had stuck in genres, we would have probably all be lost. Urban is obviously what everybody chases.
Mm-hmm.
Right now, the big new sound is I'm a piano.
Yeah.
But we have had such an incredible, we get about 60 tracks.
Sorry, can you say that again? You said I'm a piano.
I'm a piano. Yes.
Tell me about it. What is I'm a piano?
Well, I mean, it's a fusion, I guess, of house, and I probably am not the person to talk about it, but it's a song. It's a genre that my team talk about.
Well, you've heard it here first. I'm a piano is I'm coming piano. To you guys.
And a great new South African artist called Quish Essay, but you'll see him soon.
Fantastic.
I think that what we look for is any song that we believe the artist believes in. Mm-hmm. And that there is a quality production.
All right.
We do not. I mean, I think we've signed recently from a 10-year-old opera singer,
yeah,
to a more young rock metal band, because we think that from a digital perspective, there's an audience for everybody.
Okay, so you are open to all artists, all genres.
100%.
How do they contact you or your team?
Well, the team, I mean, obviously has a mechanism through social media.
Yeah.
There's a email, which I hope you're not going to ask me what it is.
I was about to.
info@contentca.co.za.
Okay. And just for those artists who are about to email you now, just give them an idea. Who are some of the SA artists you currently represent?
So on digital, and particularly on the network operators, we represent from the likes of Yvonne Chaka Chaka to Black Coffee to Tira, Afrotainment, to Destruction Boys.
All nice small acts, yes.
To Gallo Record Company, a company very close to my heart, as you know. To brand new young up-and-coming artists like Quish. We mentioned the I'm a Piano genre.
Yeah.
I think we have over 600 labels. Wow. And artists that we represent.
That's amazing.
Yeah. So it's
over 600.
Over 600 labels,
well,
and artists.
So it's obviously a tough choice to make, right? But the next question is even harder. So in the last 5 years, I mean, who do you think is SA's hottest act or like right now? And who's doing what? If you had to pick a song, what song would you pick from the modern artists?
Again. You know, I'm going to again go personal on this. When something hits me hard and it's my heart. I may not necessarily. That's why we have A&R people, because music for me is very emotional. And there is a young artist whose voice I've fell in love with, an artist by the name of Mlindo. I think I've pronounced it correctly, Mlindo. He is unfortunately not signed to CCA,
right.
But he has this most incredible vocal. It's just one of those haunting vocals that just touch my heart. So, and he's just burst on the scene with a song called I'm a Blesser, for all the right reasons.
Yeah.
But there's a particular song that he's done now with, I think it's Questa and Tubbsy.
Oh yes, Questa Tubbsy and Professor.
Questa, yeah. Mm. And I'm going to try and pronounce this, forgive me, Makala.
Oh my goodness. Now you're going to make me say it, isn't it?
And again, I hope I got it, but I love the song. I think I love all his songs. His album is just, it's one of my favorite. I'm going to tell you, Mlindo, this is on my soundtrack on every plane trip that I do. It makes me miss home. So, yeah, if you want to ask me, if I think that if there is an artist with a vocal capacity to take the world by storm, he is one of them.
Oh, wonderful.
Of many.
Thank you so much for gracing us with that choice and enlightening us, Antos. Next up, it's Mqala by Mlindo featuring Questa, Tubbsy and Professor. And I hope to God I said that right.
Macala, Sugu Bonkinga Kala, Hangsafunu Gushala, Xayo Minya Masaida, Xayo Dawang, Xayo Lashangatananda.
Welcome back to Hot 91.9. I'm the Eskimo Writer, and I'm sitting with Antos Stella from Content Connect Africa. Antos, thank you for being our guest tonight in SA Music Box.
Such a pleasure.
And thank you for having me. And thank you for sharing your three songs with us. I'm sure for people out there, some of these songs they may have never heard before, and you've kindly graced us with these wonderful choices to share with them. Thank you, and we'll see you soon. All the best, Antos.
Thanks, man. Thank you very much, and good luck.
Thank you. And that's it for SA Music Box with me, the Eskimo Writer, right here on Hot 91.9. That was Antos Stella, and she chose three songs that I would not have expected her to choose. But there were three wonderful choices. And don't forget, if you're budding artists out there, you can contact Antos by going to the Content Connect Africa website. And if you want to follow me, it's at Eskimo Writer across social media. We'll see you next week.